We are Team Spirit. At this Innovation Award, we are presenting a robotic solution for inspection and maintenance in a difficult to reach areas.
Yeah, we are Team Fashion and Robotics, and we are exploring ways how to increase sustainability in the textile industry through automation and robotics. And in particular, we want to create interfaces that allow researchers and designers to use these machines, even if they don't have a background coming from the robotics industry.
We are Team Jarvis from Politecnico di Milano, and here at the KUKA Innovation Award we present Jarvis, our interface that, thanks to AI, enables cobot programming at everyone's reach, without the need of knowing how to code a robot to a task.
The three finalist teams all had very different ideas, which made deciding on a winner very difficult. But that's part of what's so interesting about the Innovation Challenge, is that teams come up with such creative ideas for using their robots, and it's always impressive to see.
Well, the robot that we're using, the LBR Easy, is a completely new machine, and using it through ROS, as we've been doing in Innovation Award, is a very new application, so it came with its own challenges, both for us but also for KUKA, but we were, I think, quite successful in overcoming them and creating a nice application here.
The biggest challenge that we see in robotics right now is that cobot programming is very difficult for operators that are non-expert users. So that's why we wanted to introduce Jarvis. Jarvis enables small and medium-sized enterprises to be able to program their robot for all their tasks without the need of experts.
The greatest challenge was, of course, develop a solution, a robot solution that we can show to the crowd here.
Well, I'm very impressed from the finalist work. It was a lot of effort to implement their ideas, and we saw different advanced technologies integrated with our new KUKA Easy robot.
These three teams were all very, very strong, but from the criteria point of view, strengths in different areas. So for the fashion team, what we liked a lot is the contribution to sustainability and also opening up a completely new market. For the team Spirit of DL Air, it was great to see actually the contributions of so many technologies coming to a very advanced solution. And for the winning team, it was actually this very good fit to our portfolio and the product strategy we have started with iiQKA.
But the challenge was in that short time, to implement all of their great ideas and to show them to the automatic fair with the fixed date.
Developing a robotic system that has commercial potential is always challenging, and I was very glad to see the teams tackling real-world problems that robots can actually be helpful with.
I very appreciated to be part of the jury. We had those technical discussions with the team, which were really interesting, and I see here the chance really to change the world with the new ideas, which is really the innovation world.
And the winner is Team Jarvis.
The judges appreciated how Team Jarvis centered the capabilities of the KUKA robot arm, taking advantage of how it's collaborative and easy and safe to use, even for people without robotics experience.
We have to realize what we have done here and then try to go back to Milan and try to understand what could be the next step, probably. Bringing this to a higher technology level, and then we'll see.
Well, being part of the KUKA Innovation Award gives you access to KUKA developers, so you can really go into the depths of the robot, and I think this is a very good opportunity for everyone to pursue.
It's really great that KUKA offers this Innovation Award, because different researchers who are considering technology transfer, they can present their solutions, not just to research institutions, but also wide audience in industry.
Industrial intelligence.